My fellow Americans, the war in Afghanistan is now over.
President Biden moving to mark an end to the most acute crisis of his administration.
I refuse to continue a war that was no longer in the service of the vital national interest of our people.
As the country, after two decades, thousands of lives and trillions of dollars, seeks to turn the page on America's longest war.
I was not going to extend this forever war. And I was not extending a forever exit.
Biden delivering on a campaign pledge that has long been popular for a country fatigued and, in many cases, apathetic about the war. But still facing major questions in the wake of the unprecedented U.S.-led evacuation that got more than 122,000 people out of the country. Yet left more than 100 American citizens who want to leave Afghanistan still on the ground. Biden making a point of noting the support he had across the administration and military to leave by the deadline.
Leaving August the 31st is not due to an arbitrary deadline. It was designed to save American lives.
Failing to deliver on this explicit pledge from just 13 days ago.
If there's American citizens left, we're going to stay till we get them all out.
Biden making clear U.S. diplomatic efforts will be singularly focused on evacuating those Americans.
And for those remaining Americans, there is no deadline. We remain committed to get them out if they want to come out.
But with thousands of Afghan allies also still stuck in the country, one clear reality, the U.S. efforts in the country are far from over, even if its military is now gone.
I don't think enough people understand how much we have asked of the 1% of this country who put that uniform on.
The fallout from a frenzied, chaotic, and bloody final 16 days is just beginning. Congressional hearings and probes slated for the coming weeks on a withdrawal that has drawn sharp criticism from both parties. The administration has pledged to launch its own internal review. Biden even facing blowback from some of the families of service members killed by a suicide attack during the evacuation efforts.
He talked a bit more about his own son than he did my son, and that didn't sit well with me.
The White House declining to respond to critical comments from family members. But Biden saying the 13 servicemen and women who died would never be forgotten.
We owe them and their families a debt of gratitude we can never repay, but we should never, ever, ever forget.